Hello students, in today's video, I will be explaining about another center of Vadabhi Chalukyan art, Aiholi. Before going to the video, if anyone is seeing the channel without subscribing, please do subscribe to my channel and share it with your friends. And also click the bell button to receive notifications whenever I upload new videos. So now let us get into the video. Aiholi. This was another center of Badami Chalukyan art. So in the last video, we have studied about the cave temples of Badami. So now we will see about another center of Badami Chalukyan art, that is Aiholi. It was also a very famous trading center. We can see a number of temples of Chalukyan art here. So if you visit Aiholi, you can see a number of temples which can be said as examples of Chalukyan art here. So let us see a few temples. The first one, Lath Khan temple. It is the first of the temples of Chalukyan art. So Lath Khan temple is the first of the temples of Chalukyan art. It has a Mukhamandapa, Garbhagriha, with a Nandi idol in front of the temple. So there is an entrance, there is a Mukhamandapa, and the main Garbhagriha has a Nandi idol in front of the temple. A special feature of this Lath Khan temple is Garbhagriha on top of the Garbhagriha. So this is a very notable feature of this temple, that is, there is a Garbhagriha on top of the Garbhagriha. Henry Cousins, who were art critics, called it Vaishnava temple because of the sculpture of Garuda on the door of the Garbhagriha. So there was a confusion regarding this temple. Why? Because in the front of the Garbhagriha we see a Nandi idol, and on the door of the Garbhagriha we see the sculpture of Garuda. So Henry Cousins are of the opinion that it is a Vaishnava temple. So Aiholi was another center of Badami Chalukyan art. It was also a very famous trading center. There are a number of temples which can be said as examples of Chalukyan art here. One of the first of the temples is Lath Khan temple. It has a Mukhamandapa and a Garbhagriha with a Nandi idol in front of the temple. And a special feature of this temple is Garbhagriha on top of the Garbhagriha. Henry Cousins, who were art critics, called it Vaishnava temple. Why? Because there was a sculpture of Garuda on the door of the Garbhagriha. Now, why is it named as Lath Khan temple? Since a Muslim saint by the name Lath Khan lived here for a number of days, people called it Lath Khan temple. So that was a story. Why? Because there was a Muslim saint by the name Lath Khan. He lived in this temple for a number of days. Because of that, people started calling this temple as Lath Khan temple. So this is the first important temple of Aiholi. The next temple is Durga temple. This is a very special temple among the temples of Aiholi. It is a sun temple designed on the model of horseshoe and Buddhist Chaityalaya. So here also you can see a speciality. The name is Durga temple, but it is a sun temple. It is designed on the model of horseshoe and Buddhist Chaityalaya. The Shikhara of the temple resembles the Shikhara of Orissa temple. The Shikhara, that is the topmost portion of the temple, resembles the Shikhara of the famous Orissa temple. Since the temple is surrounded by the fort wall, it is called as the fort temple, or the fort means Durga. That is why it is called as Durga temple. So here also there is a reason why it is called Durga temple. It is surrounded by a fort wall. Okay, for like protection we cover with fort. That fort is called Durga. Because it is covered by a fort wall, it is called as a fort temple or Durga temple. It has a Rangamandapa with two rows of pillars and veranda on the two sides till the Garbhagriha. So there is a Rangamandapa and there are two rows of pillars on the sides of the Rangamandapa and veranda on the two sides, and that veranda goes till Garbhagriha. So once more, the Durga temple is a very special temple among the temples of Aihole, and it is a sun temple designed on the model of horseshoe and Buddhist Chaityalaya. The shikara of this temple resembles the shikara of Orissa temple. Since the temple is surrounded by the fort wall, it is called as the fort temple or Durga temple. It has a rangamandapa with two rows of pillars and veranda on the two sides till Garbhagriha. Now the next temple at Aihole is Huchimalligudi temple. So there is no detailed description is not given in your textbook regarding this temple. Only thing which is given is it is a small temple with a simple style and has square pillars. So Huchimalligudi temple is a temple at Aihole. It is a small temple with simple style and square pillars. The next temple is a very famous Meghuthi Jain temple. It is situated on a small hill near Aihole and was built by Ravikirti. So Meghuthi Jain temple was built on a small hill near Aihole and it was built by Ravikirti. The Aihole inscription is written on the eastern wall of this temple. So that is a speciality of Meghuthi Jain temple. The famous Aihole inscription is written on the eastern wall of this temple. The temple was built in Dravida style and has a Mukhamandapa, Madhyarangamandapa and Garbhagriha. So it is made in the famous South Indian Dravida style and it has a Mukhamandapa, Madhyarangamandapa and Garbhagriha. It is called Melagudi as it is built on the hill. So why the name Meghuthi? Because before it was called as Melagudi, that is why, because it was built on a hill. And that, according to scholars, gradually Melagudi became Meghuthi. Okay, that is why it is called as Meghuthi Jain temple. The other important temples of Aihole are Jyotirlinga, Malligarjuna, Siddheshwara, etc. So there are many other temples at Aihole, Jyotirlinga, Mallikarjuna, Siddheshwara, etc. So Meghuthi Jain temple is situated on a small hill near Aihole. It was built by Ravikirti. The famous Aihole inscription is written on the eastern wall of this temple. The temple was built in Dravida style. It has a Mukhamandapa, Madhyarangamandapa and Garbhagriha. It is called Meghuthi or temple because it was built on a hill. It is also called as Melagudi, which later came to be called as Meghuthi. The other important temples of Aihole are Jyotirlinga, Malligarjuna, Siddheshwara, etc. Ramalinga temple, which is half a mile away from Aihole, has three Garbhagrihas. So if you see, the area itself is covered by temples. So the Ramalinga temple, which is almost half a mile away from Aihole, it has three Garbhagrihas. So next, let us see about Pattadakallu. Its ancient name was Kisuvolalu. So Pattadakallu's ancient name was Kisuvolalu. So this also was a very famous center where we can see a number of temples related to Badami Chalukyan art. So many temples of Badami Chalukyan art are situated in Pattadakallu. Kashi Vishwanatha temple, Papanatha, Jambulingeshwara temple, etc. are some of the temples which were built in Nagara style. So there were temples built in different styles. So some of the temples which were built in Nagara or North Indian style, that is Kashi Vishwanatha temple, Papanatha temple, Jambulingeshwara temple, etc. Now there were also temples built in Dravida style. So which were those? Virupaksha temple, Mallikarjuna temple, Sangameshwara temple, etc. were built in Dravida style. So in Pattadakallu, its ancient name was Kisuvolalu. Many temples of Badami Chalukya art are situated here. And some temples were built in Nagara style and some built in Dravida style. The temples built in Nagara style are Kashi Vishwanatha temple, Papanatha temple, Jambulingeshwara temple, etc. And those built in Dravida style are Virupaksha temple, Mallikarjuna temple, Sangameshwara temple, etc. Now let us see about Virupaksha temple, Lokesh or Lokeshwara temple. This is one of the most important among the temples at Pattadakal. Already we have seen the Virupaksha temple is the most important among the temples of Pattadakal. It was built in the memory of three victories over the Pallavas by Vikramaditya II. So this temple was built by Vikramaditya II in memory of his three victories over the Pallavas. The architect of the temple was Anirvadachari Gunda. So the architect of Virupaksha temple was Anirvadachari Gunda, and it is 224 feet long and 105 feet broad. So the temple, the Virupaksha temple is 224 feet long and 105 feet broad. The temple looks like it is being held by lions and elephants holding the beam. So the base of the temple, you can see lions and temples, they look like they are holding the beams of the temple. That is how the temple is made. So the temple looks like it is being held by lions and elephants holding the beams. A huge sculpture of Nandi can be seen in the Nandi Mandapa in front of the temple. So in front of the Virupaksha temple, there is a Nandi Mandapa, and in that you can see a huge sculpture of Nandi. The temple has a Mukhamandapa, Mahamandapa, Garbhagriha with a Shikara in Dravida style. So the Virupaksha temple or Lokeshwara temple has a Mukhamandapa, Mahamandapa, Garbhagriha and Shikara in Dravida style. The idol of Surya Murthy in the Ardha Mandapa is the most beautiful. So Virupaksha temple or Lokeshwara temple, it is one of the most important temple at Pattadakal. It was built in memory of the three victory over Pallavas by Vikramaditya II. The architect of this temple was Anirvadachari Gunda, and the temple looks like it is being held by lions and elephants holding the beams. A huge sculpture of Nandi can be seen in the Nandi Mandapa in the temple. And the temple has Mukhamandapa, Mahamandapa, Garbhagriha with a Shikara in Dravida style. And the idol of Surya Murthy in the Ardha Mandapa is the most beautiful. Now let us see about the Mallikarjuna temple or Trilokeshwara temple. So about this temple also, there is only a few information given in your textbook. This temple was built by Trailoka Mahadevi, who was another queen of Vikramaditya II. So the Mallikarjuna temple, also the called as Trailokeshwara temple, it was built by Trailoka Mahadevi, who was another queen of Vikramaditya II. So all these are the details regarding the temples which can be said as examples of Chalukya of Badami art. These all temples are the main examples, or these can be said as the main contribution of Chalukyas towards art. So I hope you have understood all the points and all the examples very clearly. If you have any doubt, you can ask in the comment section. And if you like the video, please do subscribe to my channel and also share it with your friends. I hope to see you all soon in the next video. Thank you for watching.